this afternoon I'm going to talk to you about one of the pressing issues that I confronted in my own life, and that was going through job burnout, job meltdown. In 2002, I experienced, and I've spoken to this effect before in my blogs, and I think I might have even done a YouTube video on it. And what I'm going to talk about is what I term was severe meltdown, which happened when I tried continuously to look for employment and I found I was unsuccessful. Okay, to begin with, I'll explain the circumstances to what actually happened to cause this problem. It was in my earlier life began after my diagnosis of Asperger's syndrome. I worked first of all in the Queensland Parliamentary Library, and I worked there for 6 months. I really enjoyed this job. It was probably the best job I've had in my working life. And anyhow, soon after that finished in 1999, and when I waited a couple of years to enter a traineeship with the state government department here in Queensland, which went for 12 months, and once again the usual scenario was that once the job ended, you know, the manager, general manager, was being replaced and someone else was coming in. So any possibilities of getting employment, which were sort of in the pipeline, just never came to fruition. Anyhow, this is the point of which I could work up to full time. After that, I just found, like, I found full-time work a challenge. Like, I had lots of issues with sleep deprivation, and I was virtually at one stage just sort of, because I wasn't getting enough sleep, I was just constantly eating food, which of course created I got some health issues associated with that. And it was after the 12 months that I, you know, cutting a long story short, that I was again unemployed. Okay. In this period, I constantly found I wasn't getting employment. I wasn't getting anywhere. I tried to join disability employment agencies. I was actually with an employment agency, and I wasn't getting anywhere with the employment agency. And at the time, I took it upon myself that in order to make myself employable, I had to do some sort of volunteer work. So what I chose to do was to work in a private school library. And so I worked there. I didn't want to work there full time because I wasn't getting paid, and I thought that the incentive was if my work was good to a good standard, then I might be considered to go on the payroll. Well, that never came to fruition anyhow. But I worked in as a volunteer in the school library for 2 years, and I would go in for two mornings a week. I'd work 3 hours and just mainly doing shelving books and doing minor book repairs, etc. And I worked in this job as a volunteer for 2 years, and this grammar school decided to build a middle school, and there were these sort of promises, which I later found to be empty, of the possibility of me actually working, getting a job within the middle school. So I never liked sucking up to people, so I tried to refrain from such activity. And I tried and tried and tried to do everything right to get a job within the middle school. And I went through the employment consultant and I said, look, I want to, you know, there's a job going here. Can you help me to get my qualifications ready, etc.? I found that I was doing most, if all, not all the work. He was doing very little. And I was actually contacting the school myself, time after time, to eventually find I was unsuccessful. And it was like I just virtually fell off a cliff. It was like I just felt like, what's the purpose of life? What is the why am I here if I don't have any purpose? I was constantly experiencing very high levels of anxiety, and I found it very difficult to be able to see any point in getting out of bed early in the morning, and what exactly my purpose of life was. I felt I was I'm going to forever to be on a disability support pension, and I just virtually went into sort of meltdown. It was like a transformation, which I can't explain, where I felt paralyzed. I was experiencing anxiety shocks every 5 minutes. I just couldn't function. I felt at a total loss in myself as a person. And I just thought, what is the point of living if I can't be employable and so forth? So I had to take it upon myself to do something about this. So I went onto medication because the anxiety had to be controlled. So I went onto medication, and then I found that I was able to control the anxiety, and I joined another disability employment agency and was able to get part-time work after much hard work and effort, working for a disability service provider, which was mainly part-time admin work, processing timesheets and doing admin duties. This job was eventually become redundant or make me redundant, and I also got a job through the employment agency working in a parliamentary library because I got a Vietnamese employment consultant who was much more determined than the previous one. So eventually I was able to get employment in the job I have today. Look, a burnout in ASPEs or anybody in finding employment is not a fun experience, especially when you experience high levels of anxiety, and these levels of anxiety cannot be contained. It's a feeling of meltdown, a feeling of hopelessness, a feeling that life isn't going anywhere. And people don't see, they didn't see what I was going through. And it's really not a very pleasant experience. But for any adult that has gone through meltdown, I would encourage you not to give up in finding a job. I would say to you to keep trying, even though it's tough. Don't give up. Look into what I'm doing, trying to get software testing in this region of the world, and hopefully follow the work I do and my own examples and the book that I've written. It is a terrible experience to be in, and I know of several adults that have gone through this process, this meltdown period, and believe me, it's no fun. But there is hope at the end of the tunnel, and I just encourage any adult out there, don't give up on this. Just keep trying, because you will get a job. You just have to believe in yourself. And even if you have to go somewhere that offers a disability employment service, then I'd encourage you to do that, than to just accept that you're on a disability support pension for the rest of your life. Anyhow, I hope this video has been of help, and please keep watching my YouTube video channel. Thanks very much.